In this video, we work through an example using case 2 of the chain rule for functions of two variables. The chain rule case 2. If z equals f of xy, x equals g of st, and y equals h of st, then partial z partial s equals partial z partial x times partial x partial s plus partial z partial y times partial y partial s. And partial z partial t equals partial z partial x times partial x partial t plus partial z partial y times partial y partial t. Notice that everything in this definition is a partial derivative. We can't find dz ds and dz dt because x and y are both functions of two variables. We can only find partial derivatives in this case. Also, notice that it's always basically the outside function times the inside function, or the derivatives of the outside function times inside function. Example, use the chain rule to find partial z partial s and partial z partial t, where z equals e to the x plus 2y, x equals s over t, and y equals t over s. Looking back at our definition, first, we need to find partial z partial x and partial z partial y. This is like taking the derivative of the outside function if you're more comfortable thinking of it in those terms. So, z equals e to the u, and u equals x plus 2y. Z prime of u is e to the u, since the derivative of e to the u is e to the u. This is equivalent to e to the x plus 2y. The derivative of u with respect to x is 1, so u sub x equals 1. The derivative of u with respect to y is 2, so u sub y equals 2. Now we need to plug x equals s over t and y equals t over s into the z prime expression. So e to the x plus 2y equals e to the s over t plus 2t over s. So partial z partial x equals z prime u times u sub x, and u sub x equals 1, so partial z partial x equals e to the s over t plus 2t over s. And we don't need to write times 1. Partial z partial y equals z prime u times u sub y. And u sub y is 2, so we have 2 times e to the s over t plus 2t over s. So now we have the derivatives of the outside function. Now we need to find the derivative of the inside functions, x and y. So now we need to find partial x partial t, partial y partial t, partial x partial s, and partial y partial s. X equals s over t, which can also be written as s times t to the negative 1. So partial x partial t equals negative s times t to the negative 2, just using the power rule of derivatives. This is equal to negative s over t squared. Partial x partial s equals t to the negative 1, which is 1 over t. So file these away for later when we put it all together. Now y equals t over s, which is equivalent to t times s to the negative 1. So partial y partial t equals s to the negative 1, which is 1 over s. Partial y partial s equals negative t times s to the negative 2, which is equal to negative t over s squared. Notice that we're using a lot of algebra, particularly laws of exponents, to simplify as we go. Now we put it all together using the chain rule. Partial z partial t equals partial z partial x times partial x partial t plus partial z partial y times partial y partial t. So this gives us e to the s over t plus 2t over s times negative s over t squared plus 2e to the s over t plus 2t over s times 1 over s. So there's our partial z partial t. Now we want partial z partial s. So this is equal to partial z partial x times partial x partial s plus partial z partial y times partial y partial s. So we have e to the s over t plus 2t over s times 1 over t plus 2e to the s over t plus 2t over s times negative t over s squared. And we're done. Just be sure to take all of the partial derivatives before putting everything together with the definition. Also, notice that the only variables in my final answer are s and t, the two independent variables. If you end up with an x or y in your answer, then you're not done. Now you've seen case 1 and case 2 of the chain rule for functions of two variables. We can generalize this to functions of many variables. So the generalized chain rule is, if u equals f of x1, x2, up through x sub n, and each x sub j is a function of t1, t2, up through t sub m, then partial u partial t sub I equals partial u partial x sub 1 times partial x sub 1 partial t sub I plus partial u partial x sub 2 times partial x sub 2 partial t sub I plus dot 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 plus partial u partial x sub n times partial x sub n partial t sub I. So notice that it's always the derivative of the outside function with respect to a certain x variable times the derivative of that x variable with respect to the given t variable. And that's the generalized chain rule.